Just the other day, Alfie Hillman asked about Lunar Wobsters and the return of Quick Bits at that. And to that, I said, sure, why the heck not? But let us just talk all Wobsters at that point, shall we? We shall, and trust me, Wobsters are an incredible food source that everyone should know about. So, allow me to learn you. And first things first, we must respect just how accessible wobsters truly are. They spawn from what are known as wobster mounds, and these mounds themselves can be found all along the edges of our maps within the coastal oceans. Of course, World Generation will have its way with just how many mounds will be present and where. But the fact that these meals on wheels are so darn close to shore that sailing is just an afterthought is one to appreciate. But their accessibility does not end there. For you see, with no way to net or cage anything out on the water and don't starve together as of yet, darn near every sea creature is obtainable with but the sea fishing rod. And not only that, you won't even need a lure or bait to catch these cool crustaceans. Sure, a bait and lure will help a wee bit, even if it is just a twig or berry combination, but the point is that at the cost of but a board and some silk, you can have the means of catching unlimited wobsters with no extra hassle and can do so forever, as the rod itself has no durability. Just incredible. But now, as for catching the wobsters themselves, you will have to wait for dusk or night, as only then will they spawn from the wobster mounds. They do so every 2 minutes, and while only two wobsters can be spawned from a single mound at a time, they respawn in a minute and a half alone regardless, so I would not worry about their numbers. But all that said, what is the deal with the wobsters anyways? Well, it's best that you remember that when you do catch them, they are still alive. So, if you happen to drop one for a bit and forget to grab them, know that they are going to get up and run towards the nearest source of water. You can't actually grab them at this point. So, you'll have to murder them quickly, but as you can see, since live wobsters appear to do nothing for us in terms of stats, it looks like murder is our only option. But hold the stinking presses, Beard. A dead wobster doesn't even do diddly squat with regard to stats anyways, and I thought you said that wobsters were a great food source. So, what gives? What gives is that you shouldn't murder the beast in your inventories. You should boil them alive within your crockpots. Lobster Dinner is a Don't Starve shipwreck dish that has recently landed on the shores of Don't Starve Together. And at the cost of one live lobster, very important, butter, and two fillers that cannot be meat, other fish, or ice, the dish will restore 60 health, 37.5 hunger, and a whopping 50 sanity, a buttery munch. Obviously, the butter is the most limiting factor, but if you learn how to farm butterflies to at least mitigate that, you should be okay now and then. However, while lobster dinners are in fact great, I implore you to shoot for lobster bisque instead, at least in the majority of cases. One lobster, one chunk of ice, and two twigs for another fishy dish that will also restore 60 flip in health, 25 hunger, and 10 sanity a slurp. Oh yes, now you can see why wobsters should be on your radars. So good, and so easy to get to. And while that may be the extent of wobsters found near the mainland, it is still time to talk about what Alfie wanted all along. Lunar wobsters. Found in moon glass mounds, these celestial beings are too found right off land. Only, they'll be waiting for you off the coast of the lunar islands instead. Sadly though, as awesome looking as these things are, they don't actually add all that much to the conversation. All in all, they work exactly the same as their distant cousins. However, lunar wobsters cannot actually be eaten or even used in crockpots. Instead, murdering them provides a shard of moonglass and that's it. Still, they're a nice touch to the celestial stuff. But one last note here. While we can mine both types of wobster spawning mounds, doing so is an absolutely terrible idea. Sure, you'll actually get more than two wobsters to spawn from them through doing this, but you've also just destroyed the spawn forever, as they are not renewable currently. Plus, even though they drop rocks and moonglass shards, chances are you're just gonna lose the resources to the water anyways, so there's literally no point. Don't mine. Fish. And there you have it, everyone. Specifically, Elfie. Wobsters in Don't Starve Together. Abundant, accessible, and easily lead to some insanely beneficial recipes. Yup, you really should keep them at the ready. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all. Get fishing, and I'll see ya in the next one. Bye-bye.